So what kind of command support are we getting for Octave or MATLAB for bilinear transform? So bilinear transform in Octave or MATLAB. And there's a convenient command called bilinear. And this takes three arguments: numerator, coefficients, comma, and then denominator, coefficients, should abbreviate this here, and then comma fs. And as we know, usually what we do is we are setting fs to 1 to have this as a normalized frequencies here. And then the output is essentially our array for numerator and denominator for our digital filter here. Digital filter coefficients. So simple as that. The only pitfall is here that these analog coefficients here, they need to be specified in falling powers of S. So we need to be careful with that. So it starts something like with B1, and this is then S to N plus B2 S to N minus 1 plus, and so on. And then this obviously runs till here B to N plus 1 without any S at the end. And therefore we need to be careful if we are doing that. And so therefore, as an example, let's take again our bandpass transfer function here from our resonator. So S minus S infinity and S minus S infinity star. So this one we had before. And so if we multiply this out, so we need to get now the powers of S here in this case. So we've got S square and then minus S and S infinity star. And then we've got S and then S infinity and then plus S infinity and S infinity star. And so, and then this is S divided by S square and then minus S and then S infinity star plus S infinity plus S infinity and multiplied with S infinity star. So with that we've got our coefficients here. So we could put a 1 here in front of it. So then we've got here our first coefficient. So that's our second coefficient. And that's our third coefficient. And I've already drawn this away. That is basically in descending orders of S here. S square, S and no S. And this is here S, but in descending order. So this is then plus 0, because we need to basically create padding here. just that MATLAB or Octave knows this is the first power of S here. So let's do that now. So and define S infinity as before, so we don't that we have the resonator definition. So we had this already specified before, and I can just copy and paste that in it here. And so let's first start here by setting our frequency to 0.1 without a warp, so that we see the difference here. Q factor is 10. And so now let's define our S as before for our resonator here. And so now the interesting step now is to create our digital coefficients here. So bilinear. And so now first the numerator here, so that's factor one. So let's just draw one in front of it here. So that's one and then a zero. So that's one and zero. And then so now the coefficients down here, so the first one is a one. So that's our first coefficient, this one here. So the second one is just so the negative sign, and then S plus, or if we just write this down there, how it is, conjugate of S plus S. And then the last one is S multiplied conjugate of S. And so we close that. And then the last bit of our command is the sampling rate here, and we just set this to zero. So with that, we've got now our coefficients out here, B and A. And so what we can do now with that is we can just look at the frequency response of our filter. And for this, we are using again our handy command frequency Z, which is just needs to get these two coefficients here. So the FIR coefficients and A are the recursive ones. And then we are creating our frequency vector here, 0.5. And with that, then we can plot the frequency response of our filter. So here we see now our frequency response here. And remember, so far I haven't done any pre-warping. So I just did the bilinear transform. And so therefore the frequency response is slightly off. At lower Q factors is slightly off anyway, but this is here not exactly 0.1. So let's see if we can improve this by doing our pre-warping here, by creating a proper analog frequency here now. And so our pre-warping is essentially that we are first creating our omega as 2 multiplied pi multiplied by f. So that's our omega now. And so now we're just creating a new omega by 2 times tangens of omega half. So remember, our t is 1, so therefore we don't need to worry about that. So now we've got a pre-warped omega. So now our S here is defined in F and not in omega. So therefore we just bring it back to a frequency. So we just divide our omega by 2 pi and get now our pre-warped frequency out there. Let's see what this is. So we see it's nearly 0.1, but it's just a bit higher. And so So with that, hopefully, because this peak here just now was a bit too low, so hopefully this pushes this now directly over the 0.1 here. So what we just need to do is just steal the definition of S here and calculate our new zeros and poles and use then the bilinear function here, creating a new frequency response just to make it comparable. Let's just create another figure for this and keep the other one also on the screen here. So now we've got here the warped version, and this was the unwarped version, and this looks pretty much on 0.1. Let's see if this is now a bit better. Yeah, so that's nearly 0.1, it's a bit less, but we know that only at infinite Q it's hitting the 0.1 precisely. So compared to that, so here, let's go a bit closer in this here. So here we had our peak here at roughly 0.095. So here the peak is nearly at 0.1. So the pre-warping has moved the peak here to the right position. So now with that, we know basically how to design our IRR filter with the help of the bilinear transform, just by putting our analog filter coefficients in here and just using the bilinear command, and we're getting our digital coefficients out there, and with these ones we can directly build an IRR filter.